All right, you guys, it's that time again. It's time to talk some beauty trash, AKA all the products that I have used up in their entirety. I thought, you know, my bag's getting kind of full here. It's probably a good time to film another one of these. I used to film them monthly, and then it turned into like bi-monthly, and then it turned into like every 6 months. So I really don't have a schedule for this. The schedule is when my bag gets full. Okay, first up, I'm seeing a ton of Bath & Body Works products. I feel like inevitably, I always go through a lot of these. I pretty much exclusively use Bath & Body Works for shower gel and lotion, and it's typically the same scents every month, so you're probably like, yeah, yeah, we get it, Melissa. But I have Strawberry Pound Cake and Vanilla Bean Noel. This is a shower gel. These are both shower gels, actually. Vanilla Bean Noel shower gel, Vanilla Bean Noel body lotion, Strawberry Pound Cake body lotion, Vanilla Bean Noel body lotion. I think that is it. I go through, oh no, here's another one. This is body lotion, Vanilla Bean Noel. So I go through about one or two of those every month or so. As far as dry shampoo goes, I only have two this time. I double checked, unless one is really hiding in there. These are the jumbo sizes, so these take me about a month and a half, 2 months to go through. They're both in the same scent, floral and fruity blush. My favorite, I don't think they make it anymore, you guys. I haven't been able to find it in probably a year, so I'm sad. It was like the bright and lively floral. It was the colorful bottle. This is like the next best thing. It's not as good, but it's the next best thing. I use this Batiste so much. I love it. It's so good if you have oily hair. I only wash my hair once every like 6 days, so it gets really oily. This is a really powdery dry shampoo, so it really soaks up the oil, and then you just kind of like scratch it away and there's no like residue left behind. I have a couple of things of these little Kirkland makeup wipes. I'm actually shocked that I have two. It takes me a really long time to go through these. I usually keep a pack up here at my vanity to kind of like wipe my hands off as I'm swatching or filming videos. And then I also have a pack in my bathroom that I use here and there. I'm gonna take it traveling and stuff, but it usually takes me forever. So I'm kind of shocked that I have two of them in here. These are decent makeup wipes. I mean, it is what it is. I'm not gonna spend a ton of money on something that you use once and then throw away. I have a couple of non-Bath & Body Works shower-related products. So this is the brand Rituals. I've talked about them in a couple of different videos. It's a luxury body care brand that's sold at Sephora. I think they also sell them at maybe Nordstrom. Oh, it smells so good. This was like the Fresh Lotus scent or something like that. I don't remember exactly. So this is the foaming shower gel, and then is it foaming shower gel? Yeah, something like that. And then the body scrub. This body scrub was really good. I mean, it is leaps and bounds better than Bath & Body Works, if I'm being honest. The foaming shower gel, it was cool. It was fun. I think regular shower gel works just as well, but it smelled really good. It was a nice, like, treat for myself. But I don't know that I'm going to spend the extra money to get luxury body care products when I can just use Bath & Body Works. I also have this body conditioner by Lush. This is their Rose Argan. It's like the OG body conditioner, in shower, body lotion, whatever you want to call it. Oh, this one smells so good. It smells like rose. This, I kind of forgot I had this under my sink and I rediscovered it. It expired 2 years ago, but it was still good. It still, I mean, it did the job. It didn't smell funky. The texture was fine. So, I mean, it is what it is. Lush stuff does expire pretty quickly because it's typically made with like kitchen grade ingredients. So I was shocked that this was still good. After you shower, you turn off the water and then you put this on you and then you rinse it off. And once you get out of the shower, you kind of pat dry instead of wiping dry, and your body is lotioned, like conditioned, like you would do for your hair. I have a sunscreen in here. This is by Biosense. This is their Squalene and Zinc Sheer Mineral Sunscreen. This was a really good sunscreen. I didn't love the smell of it, I will just be honest. I'm a big smell person, especially sunscreen scents. So I struggled with the smell of this, but I liked it. I used the whole thing up. So it's a mineral sunscreen, which is good because it's pregnancy safe. I don't think I will purchase it again simply because there's other mineral sunscreens that I like a little bit better. I have three of these Native deodorants in here. I know this one I used completely up. It's Sweet Peach and Nectar. This is a really good scent. Like, this is my favorite Native scent, by the way. Oh, it's so peachy and just, oh, it smells like a juicy peach, and the scent sticks around. I have buttercream and French vanilla, and then blood orange and clove. This one still has a ton left in it. I did not like this scent at all. Oh, I mean, it smells fine for some reason on my body. It just didn't mix well. The scent, I just couldn't do it. And then the buttercream and French vanilla I did end up using up too. So I will say that since becoming pregnant, I have switched back to regular antiperspirant, like Secret with the aluminum in it. Because for some reason, this pregnancy, my hormones are totally different than they were with my last pregnancy and pre-pregnancy. I have really bad BO, like really bad BO, you guys. And I can't stand the scent of it. My own BO was making me nauseous. And the native just wasn't cutting it anymore. It wasn't doing the job. It wasn't doing anything really. So sadly, I had to switch back to aluminum antiperspirant. I'm hoping that after I'm, you know, done with this pregnancy, I can go back to native because I don't necessarily love putting aluminum on my underarms. I have two facial moisturizers in here. Yeah, okay, that's not a moisturizer. Two facial moisturizers in here. One of them is by Fresh. I actually just finished this one up today. I love this facial moisturizer. It smells like rose, which if you can't tell is one of my favorite scents. This is their Rose Deep Hydration Face Cream. This is the newer version of it, so they reformulated it and made it better, more hydrating, better ingredients. So yeah, I finished it all the way up. I love this. I wouldn't say I have super dry skin by any means. I probably have more just like normal skin. And this is perfect for that. And then I also finished up the Kate Somerville Goat Milk Moisturizing Cream. This, I feel like I blew through it really, really fast. Typically, this is sold with a pump, like an airless pump. But this container didn't have that. It was very, very liquidy. And it was just, I used it really fast. So I feel like if you're gonna buy this, make sure you get the version that has the pump on the top because it's easier to control the amount of product that you use that way. I missed this when I was talking about hair products, or did I not talk about hair products yet? No, I didn't talk about hair products yet, did I? No, okay, I'm losing it, you guys. Pregnancy brain over here. So this is the Redken'd Diamond Oil. This actually had a tiny bit left in it. This took me forever to finish up. I'm talking, I had this for like 7 years, you guys, and it's pretty big. It's 3.4 fluid ounces, and you only need one pump every single time you wash your hair. And like I said before, I only wash my hair once every 6 days. So because of that, you can see why it took me so long to finish this up. It actually got to the point where what was left was turning like a yellowy orange brassy color. It's supposed to be clear. So that's when I was like, okay, it's gotta go. And I kind of dumped a little bit out and I was like, yeah, it's bad. So I just dumped it all out and here's the bottle. And I've already replaced it, so. Another hair product I have in here is the Brio Gio Superfoods Avocado and Kiwi Mega Moisture Hair Mask. This was a little baby sample that I got in my Ipsy bag, but I liked it so much that I actually picked up the full size sample from, or the full size tub from Ulta. It left my hair feeling so soft and so smooth, and it smells so good. It's like the kiwi that I'm smelling. I don't know, it smells so, so good. So it's a lot like their Repair Don't Despair hair mask, but it just smells a lot better. I have a couple more skincare products in here to tell you guys about. So I have this Versed Daily Dissolve Cleansing Balm. I got this at Target. This was a really good cleansing balm. It has a nice scent to it too. I picked this up in a pinch when I was traveling and I didn't have any makeup remover. It surprised me. It worked really well. It was expensive for Target. It was like $18 for this. And in my mind, I'm like, well, if I'm gonna spend $18, I might as well get, you know, like a Clinique or a more higher end brand. You know what I mean? So I don't know that I'll buy it again unless I'm in a pinch again. If I'm at Target and I need it, like I'll buy it, you know? This is the Farsali Skin Tuning Blur Perfecting Primer Serum. This, I was doing a declutter on my primers and I realized that this is pretty much gone. So I threw it in here. There's probably a little bit left in here, but I don't know that I'll repurchase this. It was fun. It was cool. You know, the dropper's kind of neat. It had a good smell. It doesn't smell anymore, but I recall it having a tropical scent when I first got it. My problem with this is it's hard to store because it has a dropper, you have to store it like this. You can't store it like this. I have another oil that I have to do the same with. So it's hard to store. You can't travel with it, and it's just kind of fussy. Do you know what I mean? I have three mascaras in here. Wow. You know what? One of them was on its way out a long time ago, and I just recently threw it in here. and that's this one right here. It's the Charlotte Tilbury Full Fat Lashes. This one dried up. I mean, this was a long, long time coming. It just hung out in my vanity for a few months before I decided to toss it. So it's not my favorite mascara by Charlotte Tilbury. I much prefer their Legendary Lashes Volume 2. Just dropped it on the floor. That mascara is fabulous. On that note, this is her Pillow Talk mascara. This one was okay. I felt like this one was a little bit smudgy. When I wore it for a long time, like hours, like 12 plus hours a day, I noticed I would get little smudges on my eyelids up here and sometimes down here. I don't like smudgy mascaras, so for that reason, I probably won't purchase this again. The packaging is beautiful. I love her Pillow Talk line. The next one is the Pat McGrath Dark Star Mascara. This is one where it was just meh, you know what I mean? I think my problem is I love my Hourglass mascara so much, the Hourglass Unlocked, that every other mascara, in my opinion, is just subpar. It's just meh, you know? Compared to that one, everything is just meh. So this one, I had the smudging problem as well. Also, the wand is pretty big, which makes it kind of hard to apply. It's very similar to Better Than Sex by Too Faced. So with products like that, if you add smudginess on top of it, it's just kind of a recipe for disaster. In my opinion, I don't think it's worth the money. Buy the Hourglass one. Buy the Hourglass Unlocked mascara. You will not regret it. It is a fantastic mascara. I have two of these NARS Smudge Proof eyeshadow bases in here. One of them is clear. Now, this one I had in my big makeup collection. And this one has the tint to it. It's like the color light. Yeah. So this one is the one I was using. It was in my everyday makeup drawer. I was using it. It dried up. You know, it's done. It's gone. It's lived its life. So I pulled this one out of my collection. Now this one was used. It wasn't brand new. I just don't remember when exactly I put it back in my big collection. So when I pulled it out to use it, I was like, this is dry. So my thought is, when I put it in there, it was probably on its way out, and then it just sat in there for so long because I was using the other one that it just dried up. So it's okay. I have another one. This is my favorite, favorite, favorite eyeshadow primer. It's clear. It does the job. The doe foot makes it so easy to apply. It is my absolute favorite. Okay, you guys, two products left and then I am done. So the first one is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Wiz, my favorite brow pencil, hands down. It has a teeny tiny itty bitty point. I wear the color taupe. I didn't use it today because I'm actually working on a Benefit brow pencil right now. And I'm also working on the Huda brow pencil. I kind of use them together, hand in hand. But this is a good one. I always have multiple backups of this because I feel like I just can't live without it. If my brows are being fussy, if other products aren't working, I just reach for this one. When I'm traveling, I grab one of these. And then this is a brow product as well, but I use it in my hairline. So this is the Urban Decay Brow Box in Bathwater Blonde. There's like something on it, yuck. So you can see the top two colors are gone. The bottom is a wax that I don't use. So this is something that this particular color was perfect for me. Bathwater Blonde, it's like their dirty blonde. They discontinued it, but I found it at TJ Maxx and I bought every single one of them that I found. And now I'm on my last one from TJ Maxx. So I'm like, I don't know what I'm gonna use when this is gone, because this is like the perfect consistency, the perfect color, especially postpartum. It worked beautifully, like for my postpartum bald spots. So I still struggle with it a little bit. You can kind of see, I put it like right here. When I pull my hair back in a bun or a ponytail, I'll put the brow powder right here to kind of fill that in. So my hair looks fuller. My hairline looks a little bit better. Okay guys, well that is the end of my empties for this round. I hope that you enjoyed watching and yeah, stay tuned for more empties videos. These are my favorite to film and I know you guys like them too because they're highly watched. They're one of the top watched videos on my channel. So I hope that you enjoyed and I'll talk to you next time.